What's up, guys? It's Bernie with 2Fab, and I am here with the dancer, model, actress, and singer, Larsen Thompson. So how did you get started in all this? Like, what of the four passions came first for you?
So my aunt, Julianne McNamara, she was actually an Olympic gymnast. So she's been in the industry forever, and I never ever thought I would get into gymnastics. So my mom was like, let's get her into dance, because my aunt's had some bad injury. So my mom's like, I don't want my daughter to like hurt anything. Let's put her in something like a little easier on the body.
Okay.
So I went into dance at 4 years old and I fell in love. I started working in the industry at 9 years old, training with like Brian Friedman and a few of like the top choreographers, and like dancing with like Janet Jackson and Christina Aguilera and like all these crazy people. And so it's just been like an amazing ride. And then from there, I was working on like commercials, and I was working on this one commercial, and they were like, we'd love to use you for our print campaign. And I'm like, what's that? And then ended up getting into modeling and signed with Next at 14 years old, and I've been with them for 3 years now. And it's just been a crazy ride. And what I love is I'm able to fuse all of them together. So I've been able to fuse my dancing and my modeling and my fashion all together with companies or just on my own, creating my own content. So it's just been amazing.
You've been in the following music videos: Beyonce's Run the World.
Yes.
Bourne's American Money, Sia's The Greatest, Katy Perry's Chain to the Rhythm, and Pink's Beautiful Trauma.
Yes.
Okay, we could be here all day if I asked you about all of them, but of all of those experiences, what was kind of your most memorable, or, you know, did you get to interact with any of the artists?
So I definitely have to say Pink Beautiful Trauma was one of my favorites so far.
Really?
So Pink wasn't in the video, and I kind of like played her, and it was back in the 50s, and what was so cool was the song's kind of about like trauma and all of that, but we kind of made it like a play where everything's happy and we're all joyful, and I have all these like 15 like boxers behind me, and we're all just like dancing and having a good time, and at the end it's like the play's over and I just like fall to the floor because I'm like, beautiful trauma.
So Kendall Jenner recently made some comments that offended certain models in the industry. Just so that we're clear with what she said, it was, I was never one of those girls who would do like 30 shows a season or whatever the F those girls do. More power to them, but I had a million jobs, not only catwalks, but everything else. She got blasted.
Yes, I saw that.
Were you offended by the comments, or did you understand where she was coming from?
You know, to be honest, I was a little like, I didn't really understand what she was trying to say. It didn't make sense to me. I was just like, we're all models, we're all in this industry. So I was kind of confused as what she wanted to really put out there. But I feel like even Kendall and all of the runway models, we all work hard in this industry. To me, it didn't offend me, but I'm just kind of like, I was kind of like, that didn't really make sense.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of confused as to where she was going with that.
Do you think that it's, she's always kind of been put down, you know, because they're like, oh, you had it easy with the famous last name, the famous parents, the famous family. Do you think that, so you're saying it's a difficult job to be in the fashion industry no matter what aspect
you're
in?
Exactly.
Do you think that she was at an unfair advantage, or the Hadid girls, for example, do you think that they're at an unfair advantage?
See, I think they were put in a position they can't control. I mean, you can't control that your mom is Yolanda Hadid and Muhammad Hadid, and you can't control that your mom's Kris Jenner. So honestly, I think like they could have gone either route in this industry. They could have gotten into acting and singing or dancing or modeling. And I think they both are so beautiful on the outside, and I've never met them before, but I think it just came naturally to them, to be honest. I mean, especially when you have parents like that and Kris, who's like a very smart woman.
Yeah.
I think it just comes, and like, they're like, oh, let me get into modeling. You know, I have the face, I'm tall, and it just kind of came, and all these designers reached out to them, and I think it comes easier to them than for some models who don't have famous parents. But I mean, that's just the industry that we're in today.
Yeah, it kind of like gets you in the door, but doesn't
completely
necessarily keep you there.
Exactly.
You have to put in the work.
100%, yeah.
Gotcha. So what's your like next step for you? You're gonna graduate high school. What would be kind of your dream path to take?
I've just gotten into singing recently, so I'm definitely working on that. I wanna put out an original song soon, in like 2 months or so, or 3 months, not really sure when I'm gonna put it out.
That is so exciting.
And then gonna continue dancing and modeling and just fusing it all together, and just like bringing everything I've done and like all of my capabilities and just all my talents that I'm so blessed to have and just like take advantage of them and spread them to the world and inspire and motivate people, because that at the end of the day is all I want to do. I want to inspire and motivate people to just be themselves and not care what other people think.